There's been a rise in ticket machine fraud across at least 5 countries in Europe. Criminals are using card skimming devices like this one, which are attached to ATMs and other places we typically insert our cards. New favourites include train and bus ticket machines, petrol station pumps and parking meters. The account information collected is then used in countries outside the EU, particularly in the US, where the more secure chip and PIN system isn't used. A company that lets users buy and sell pre-owned digital music has lost a copyright case in the US. Redigi wants to recreate the trade in second-hand records online and claim to keep things legal by deleting the original music file before sending it on to the new owner. The courts, though, didn't agree, ruling that as a copy has to be made, it's impossible to transfer digital files in the same way as a physical book or DVD. Capitol Records, the label that filed the lawsuit, now wants $150,000 damages for each infringing file. When is an April Fool's joke not an April Fool's joke? When the unbelievable turns out to be true. What was initially taken to be a prank, an internet-wide rumour that Chinese online search giant Baidu was working on homegrown Google Glass-style tech specs, was subsequently confirmed. A Baidu spokesperson said the company already had a working prototype, complete with heads-up image search and voice control. Fortunately, not every April Fool's gag turned out to be true. The President of the United States became a 9-year-old for the day.
It looks like you're expecting somebody else. But April Fool's on all y'all.
And in a sign that text speak may have gone a bit too far, Twitter announced plans to charge $5 a month for the use of vowels on the social network. Not to be outdone, Google unveiled the new sensation in search, Google Nose, which has the ability to search and experience smells in your browser. Fear not, the project also comes with a safe search option.